Hey Adam, why are you wearing a robe? Don't you have any clean clothes, Adam?
Of course I have clean clothes. I'm wearing them. Underneath this robe. Because it's so cold. Okay. Today's video probably won't be that long. It'll probably be a fairly short video. Mostly because I am so cold. And also somewhat because, I'm really tired. I haven't been sleeping. My hair is a mess. No, I'll keep that in there. I really don't have anything to make a video about today.
Hey, you want to see a little card trick? You want to see it with little cards?
Here's a very simple trick. I used to do it a lot. I'm not entirely sure what the trick is called. I just know, it's really simple. It's really easy. I call it the "this is not your card" trick because I don't show the spectator what their card is. In this case, the card being the King of Spades. I go through a few cards of the deck, pull out like four cards, see if they're the King of Spades. No, yeah. So anyway, this is not the King of Spades, so I'm going to put that there. And this one, that's not the King of Spades. This one... No, that's the Ace of Clubs. Oh, sorry, this one, that's not the King of Spades either. Okay. Go Fantasy. No, definitely not. Definitely sure that isn't the King of Spades either. But I still only have the four cards. I bet the King of Spades is in here. So do a little magic, whatever, sprinkle a little magic dust, whatever. And peel off a few, find the King of Spades. This is also a very simple card trick, and it is still pretty easy to do with these tiny cards. I have even smaller cards than this. Here's seven cards here, and we're going to pick one of these seven cards. And let's just say you're going to pick this one. Okay? You see that? So then I take the cards that are left, and I tell you, okay, so stick them somewhere in there. So think about like, here's good. Okay. So then, I say, pick a number between like 7 and 12. Let's say it's 10. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, the only reason I tell people to pick up to 12 is because I can't hold that many cards in my hand. So usually, I hope that they say 10. You see the card in there somewhere? You see it? Is it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9? That is 10 cards. Okay. So then I'm going to go through and I'm going to tell you all the cards that your card is not. And I'm just going on blind faith here that these two are not your cards. So I'm going to put those back. Also, I don't believe that this is your card. Of course, that's kind of easy, of course. That's probably not your card. This one, no, that's probably not your card. I'm going to say that this one isn't your card. That this one is not your card. These two, definitely not your card. And this one is not your card. Was I right? Well, of course I know I'm right. I'm watching myself on the camera. Okay. So here's another little trick. It's fairly simple. You're going to pick a card out of the middle of the deck. Doesn't really matter what it is. We'll say it's this card. Okay. And then we're going to put it, let's say, just put it right on top of the deck and I'll cut it in. Okay, so I cut there. And then you see I'm not breaking or anything. I really just cut there. And then I'm going to go through. Actually, what happens is the cards listen to me psychically. I snap my fingers and then your card turns face up in the deck. I probably shouldn't have already snapped my fingers. Usually if I snap twice, something else happens, but snapping once and then your card turns up upside down in the deck. You believe me? I'm gonna snap my fingers like that. Hopefully nothing bad will happen, but yeah, there we go. All right. Wait. Actually, neither one of those were your cards, was it? Well, that stinks. That's okay, though. That's okay. The Jack of Spades. See the Jack of Spades here? And then there's the Jack of Clubs here. They're actually not bad cards. They help magicians out. The Black Jacks. They help magicians find cards and stuff. I'm going to go ahead and cut again. Just so you understand what's going on here. Let's see. I'll snap my fingers again. See if they can find your card. Well, it'd be help if I actually looked through it. Do 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 do. And there's the looks like they did find a card. Is this the card that you were looking for? Let's try something else. Let's do a quick little shuffle. Okay. And that's really simple shuffle. If you didn't catch that, then you're not a real magician. I'm gonna put one jack on top and one jack on the bottom. They're gonna go through and find your card.
I'm not full of myself. I'm full of other things.
Let me try this again. I'm gonna do another quick cut, put it in the middle of the deck, did a cut. Now, I'm gonna take these jacks, and something else that the jacks can do is they transfer, like, friction and electricity and stuff. So I'm gonna tap them on the camera. Tap, 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 tap. Get the electricity from them, okay? And I'm going to rub the electricity off with my finger. See? Now, hopefully, that'll work. Oh, something almost came up. Oh. There it is. It's your card. Woo-hoo. It's a good thing you're not watching this in 3D.
I have a condition in my eyes, and I'm not entirely sure if it's a real condition or if I made it up psychologically, like if it's psychosomatic, but I always see everything in my right eye in a weird pink tint, and then in my left eye, I see everything in a blue tint. So, if you remember those old 3D glasses that were blue in one eye and red in the other eye, that's kind of what everything looks like. I told that to somebody that I used to work with, and she was really astonished by it and came up with the best question I have ever heard. She asked me, "So if you see everything like you're looking through 3D glasses, does that mean you see everything in 3D?" I did not respond.